Hello friends, welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and in this video I'm gonna show you how to make this brass fitting in SolidWorks. And for this we'll be following this sketch. Okay, and first we'll have to open a new part. And here we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane. And we'll start with the polygon. So we'll keep six sides. And now the dimension between these two lines will be 17 millimeters. Now select these two points and make them vertical. Make a small circle here, which will have the diameter 4 millimeters. Now go to features, use extruded boss base. I'll keep here mid plane. And here I'll put 5.5 millimeters. And press OK. Now we have this polygon. We'll have to make these two sides. Okay, so I will open a sketch on the top plane. I will make them with revolve boss base, but we can make them with simple circles and extrude. I'll select here hide the lines visible, and then I'll make here a rectangle. The dimension here will be 2 millimeters, okay, and here will be 5. This line will have 8.5. We can delete this. Okay. And now to make the other side. Okay, and now we'll have to define this. So this line here will have 2.5 millimeters. Okay, and from this line to this point here will be 9.32 millimeters. From this point to this line here will be 7. And now this line will have 8.5 millimeters. This line here will have the angle 60 degrees. Now we'll have to make a center line. Just like this. And now we'll have to define this. And we'll select this line and this center line, and if you keep the dimension here it will show you the radius, but if you pass it will show you the diameter. So the diameter will be 16 millimeters, and we'll do the same for this line, and here the diameter will be 13.5 millimeters. And from this line to the center line here will be 5 millimeters, and from this point to the center line will be 6 millimeters. Okay, and now we need another line here to close this. Okay, now go to features, use revolved boss base, and press OK. Perfect. Now we'll use chamfer for this face, and we'll put here 0.5 and 45 degrees and press OK. And now for this edge, and here we'll put 1 millimeter and press OK. Good. Now open a sketch on this face, and here we'll make a circle and select here plain white. This circle will have a diameter of 15.3 millimeters. Now go to features, use extruded cut, select here flip side to cut. Here we'll keep 10 millimeters and select here draft on, and here we'll put 55 degrees. Okay, and press OK. And you see the cut is made outside of our sketch. Okay, and now we'll have to mirror this on this other side, and that's why we made this polygon extruded, and we selected their mid plane, because now we'll have to use mirror, and we'll select front plane, and we'll select cut extruded, and press OK. Okay, now we'll have to make the fillet for this side and for this other side. We'll start with this one, so open a sketch on this face. Here we'll make a circle with a diameter of 14.34 millimeters. Now go to features, and from curves select helix and spiral, and here we'll select height and pitch, and the height will be 9 millimeters, the pitch will be 1.5, the start angle will select 0 degrees, and you can select here reverse direction if it's going in the opposite direction, and keep here clockwise and press OK. Now I'll have to select top plane, we'll open a sketch, normal 2, and here we'll have to make the profile for our thread, so it will be a triangle like this. Now select this point and this point, and make them horizontal. Now the angle here will be 60 degrees, and here this dimension will be 1.3 millimeters. Select this helix and this point, and select here make pierce. Now we'll make with the sketch fillet, we'll select this point, but first we'll put here 0.1. Okay, and we'll select this point, press OK. Now exit this sketch and select from features swept cut. As you can see, the sketch is already selected, and now we'll have to select the path for this swept cut, and the path will be this helix, and press OK. Our fillet is made, so right click on this helix and select here height. Okay, and now we'll have to do the same on this side, so we'll open a sketch, and now we'll make a circle with the diameter of 9.19 millimeters. Now we'll go to features, and with helix and spiral, and here we'll select height and pitch. Here the height will be 7.88 millimeters, and the pitch will be 0.75. okay, here reverse direction, here is 0, the start angle, and clockwise, press OK. Now we'll open a sketch in the top plane to make the profile, and it will be also a triangle. And now select these two points and make them horizontal. Now here the angle will be 60 degrees. Here will be 0.61. Now select this point and this helix, and select here make pierce. Now we'll make a sketch fillet to this one. So here we'll put 0.05 and select this point. Press OK. And now you have to exit the sketch, go to features, and with swift cut, we select this helix and press OK. Right click on this helix and select your height. And now we'll have to make this part from brass, so we'll go to appearance, and here you have appearance, and we go to metal and to brass and double click on this polished brass, and this is from brass. So this fitting brass is done. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video, where I'm gonna make another interesting part, maybe, if you don't know it already. Yes, and thank you, and I hope to see you in the next video. Yeah, yeah.